In this video today, I'm going to be demonstrating how to perform a power supply rejection ratio measurement using an InfiniVision X-Series oscilloscope. This type of measurement, sometimes it's simply called a PSRR measurement. You typically use either a network analyzer or frequency response analyzer to perform this measurement. What it measures is it measures a power supply's ability to reject garbage or signals that aren't supposed to be on the input. Do they sneak through to the output? So it measures the power supply's rejection capability. So it's basically a Gazenta measurement. The way the measurement is performed is the input, DC input, is modulated. It requires a summing circuit. And then you measure Vin, the DC input, with the modulation, and V out, and find out how much, and then you compare V in and V out. Now, in a normal Bode plot, it's computed as 20 log V out over V in. But in a power supply rejection ratio, it's the inverse of that. Rejection is the inverse of gain. So it's 20 log V in over V out. So what I'm going to be testing today is a evaluation board from PicoTest. This happens to be a linear power supply, has a very, very low noise output, virtually no output ripple, sub millivolt. For the summing device, I'm going to be using an accessory, again, from PicoTest. It's called the J2120A line injector. And so it has a DC input, and then it has the AC input, which I have connected to the WaveGen. Now I'm probing the input signal with a 10-to-1 passive probe, this standard probe that comes with the scope. But on the output, I'm probing with a 1-to-1 passive probe. The output signal level is going to be really, really small, and so you need to use a 1-to-1 probe. Now, this is not the best probing techniques, because this long ground lead is going to pick up other noise, environmental noise. A better probing technique would be to use an accessory that comes with your probe that will get you a very short ground like this. So this will give you the best response. But for today, I found out that I can use the standard ground lead, so that's what I'm going to do. So let's go ahead and get started with the demonstration. Well, I'm going to start with the default setup, so we can set everything up from scratch. Next, I'll go to the Analyze menu, select the Power application, and then select the Analysis menu. Now, in this menu, we can select a variety of power-related measurements if the scope is licensed with the power options, such as power quality, current harmonics, switching loss, output ripple. But if we scroll down here to the bottom, we have two frequency response measurements, which are quite unique for an oscilloscope. So we're going to perform the power supply rejection ratio measurement. Next, I'll go into the setup menu. And before I set things up, notice the question mark over here. That's a help menu. If I press that, it brings up a diagram that shows me how the measurement should be set up. And this is basically how I have it set up. So let's set it up here. First, up at the top, we have frequency mode, sweep, which is the normal mode for doing this type of test. There's also a single. We'll show that later. Next is the start frequency. The lowest it can go is 20 hertz. The highest is 20 megahertz. We're just going to use the defaults. Then points per decade, we'll use the default 10 points per decade. You can go up to 50. Then you can define which channel the scope is the input, which is the output. I'm using the default channel 1 and channel 2. And then the most difficult thing to set up is what test amplitude do you use. Now, you may not think that it matters since it's just a relative or ratio type measurement, but it's actually a very critical measurement or critical setup. So this is 200 millivolts peak to peak relative to a 50 ohm termination. I'd like to point out that most frequency response analyzers either specify the test amplitude in RMS or they specify it in dBm. So just note the difference there. Let's go ahead and just use all the default settings here. So one advantage of the scope-based solution, first of all, you can see the waveforms during the test. So The reason that's important is you can monitor for any distortion that may be occurring. Now, it looks like we're getting a pretty good measurement simply at the 200 millivolt peak-to-peak input. You notice it is a little wiggly in different areas. That is a signal-to-noise ratio problem. If we pumped up to the amplitude, we might be able to smooth that out. So we might do that in just a minute. First of all, I'd like to show you there's two independent cursors that you can move and measure the rejection and frequency. And then you can see the scaling on the left side here. It also automatically scales as it's performing the measurement. You can also scale things manually if you like. Move it up and down, or you can enter a value. So let's go back and let's perform another measurement. Let's pump up the amplitude to 700 millivolts peak to peak. That should give us a little more resolution on the measurement. Now, the green waveform is V out. Although you can't see what the volts per division setting is, but all the way across this measurement, it's set at 1 millivolt per division. So it's a very, very low level signal. Now, we just passed a frequency, I don't know if you noticed it, where there was some distortion. Now, some things to note. Now, this is a much smoother, we have much better signal to noise ratio down here at the lower frequencies, but remember that distortion you saw. Let's go back and perform a single measurement. Now, I could do it right. I could select single and enter the frequency I want to test at, but you can also go to the tabular view that shows all of the measurements that it performed, the last measurement, frequency, amplitude, and the amount of rejection. What I want to select is I'm going to perform a test at approximately 500 kilohertz. And there you can see the PSRR at 500 kilohertz, and there's the waveforms. Now notice channel one is at 1 millivolt per division. It's a very low level signal. I can improve it somewhat by turning on averaging. But the thing to notice though is it is not a sine wave. It is very distorted. So the 700 millivolts peak to peak is simply too high of a test signal. What you're going to find is that some frequencies, a lower level signal works better. And let me go into the WaveGen and let's manually reduce that until Vout begins to look like a sine wave. And there you can see it's a very, very low level signal. Now, it may help to turn on FFT and look at the purity of that sine wave to make sure there's no distortion. But anyway, what you're going to find is that some frequencies, a higher amplitude works, improves signal to noise. And at other frequencies, you need to use a lower amplitude signal so that you don't induce distortion. So I've already gone through the process of finding out what the optimum amplitudes are. And let's go back to sweep mode. And now I'm going to select a feature called amplitude profile. This is where I can optimize the amplitude at each test frequency. So I'm going to set it at 100 hertz, input 500 millivolts. And then from 100 hertz to 1 kilohertz, I'm going to keep it constant at 500 millivolts. At 10 kilohertz, I'm going to ramp up to 1 volt. And then at 100 kilohertz, I'm going to ramp back down to 500 millivolts. And then at 1 megahertz, I'm going to ramp down to 250 millivolts. 10 megahertz, same thing, 250 millivolts, all the way up to 20 megahertz. So let's run using these amplitudes, which I think are optimized. So now we have good signal to noise ratio at the low end. We can see a few little wiggles up here. We're really stressing the scope as far as how much it can actually measure. And now let's move the cursors, and you can see up here at around 25 kilohertz, the scope was able to measure about 95 dB of rejection. That's pretty impressive for a scope. At the high end, 20 megahertz, it's as low as about 40 dB. There's an inflection that occurs around 2.5 megahertz at about 42 dB. Now, this was a linear power supply, very low noise output, and we were able to get some pretty impressive rejection figures, 95 dB. If you're testing a switch mode power supply, you're going to be battling all that output ripple, and I think about the best the scope is going to be able to do in that case is probably about 60 dB. Well, thanks for watching this demonstration today on performing power supply rejection ratio measurements using an InfiniVision X-Series oscilloscopes. If you'd like to see the other videos on the other power measurements, that if they have the power option, as well as to download an application note on this particular application I showed today, go to the URL listed on your screen. Thanks.